Hi everyone, this is the third and the last part of topic 4, integumentary system. So this slide talks about the effects of aging on integumentary system. In general, the skin becomes thinner, that means the epidermis and the dermis, they become thinner. The levels of vitamin D goes down, the secretion from sweat glands and sebaceous glands also decrease, so your skin feels dry. The amount of melanin being produced by melanocyte decreases, so the hair turns gray. The hair follicles do not work as well, so you lose hair and the hair becomes thinner. Skin repair in general slows down, so elderly people are more at risk of bruises. The blood supply to the dermal layer goes down, so this makes it difficult for the body to lose heat, and that's why elderly people are more at risk of heat strokes. The hair and the body fat distribution also changes due to a decrease in the sex hormones. This figure summarizes all the effects of aging on the integumentary system. Moving on to homeostatic imbalances, that means problems in the skin. Burns are a major source of homeostatic imbalance. This is caused by heat, electricity, or ultraviolet radiation, or even chemicals, and leads to cell and tissue damage. So, what is the danger that is caused by the burns? Imagine that when the skin is burned, the outermost protective covering of the body is gone. There is nothing holding or keeping the water inside, so the body loses water fast. There is dehydration. When the body is dehydrated, along with the water that's oozing out, the body is also losing important salts and ions. So this leads to an imbalance of the electrolytes. Electrolytes are the ions such as the sodium, the calcium, the chloride, magnesium, and this leads to the body going into a circulatory shock because the volume of blood falls, blood pressure falls, the concentration of ions or electrolytes in the blood goes down. Burns are considered to be critical if either over 25% of the body has second degree burns or over 10% of the body has third degree burns, and there are third degree burns of the face, hands or feet. So how do we calculate the percentage of burns? To determine the extent of burns, there is a particular rule, it's known as the rule of nines, where the body is divided into areas and each area represents about 9% of the total body surface area. If you look at the figure, let us consider the upper limbs. So the anterior surface of both the upper limbs, each of the upper limbs is 4.5% and 4.5%, while the posterior surface is also 4.5. So if you add for the left upper limb, it's 4.5 plus 4.5, that's 9%. And for the other upper limb, again, 9%. Now, if you look at the lower limbs, the anterior surface of the right lower limb is 9%. The posterior surface is also 9%. So it's 9 plus 9, 18. And the anterior surface of the left lower limb is again 9%, and that of the posterior surface is also 9%, 9 plus 9, 18, so it's 18 plus 18, 36%. A burn is called a first degree burn if only the epidermis, that means the topmost part, is damaged. The skin looks red and swollen. It would be second degree burns if the epidermis as well as the upper layers of dermis are damaged and the skin would be red with blisters, while the burns would be third degree burns if the entire skin, that means all of the epidermis and dermis, have been burned and the burn area is painless. Infections are also common homeostatic imbalances in skin. So athlete's foot is a very common infection which is caused by fungal growth, and this is because athletes wear shoes and socks for a long time and their feet sweat, and which is ideal for fungal growth. Boils and carbuncles are caused by bacterial infection, while cold sores is caused by a virus. Contact dermatitis is a red itchy rash, and this is usually an allergic reaction. Impetigo is caused by bacterial infection, and this is a contagious disease. Psoriasis, which is shown by scaly red plaques, and the cause of psoriasis is unknown, but it could be triggered by infection or trauma or even stress. This figure shows various skin infections. Skin cancer is the most common type of cancer found in human beings, and there are two types of cancers. It is called benign if the cancer has not spread, it is still localized, and it is known as malignant if the cancer has metastasized, that means it has moved to other parts of the body. There are three types of skin cancer. The first one is known as basal cell carcinoma. This cancer starts in the stratum basal, and this is most common type but least malignant. The second type of skin cancer is squamous cell carcinoma, which starts in stratum spinosum, and it is thought to be induced by long exposure to sun. It usually metastasizes to lymph nodes if it is not detected early. The third and the most dangerous type of skin cancer is known as malignant melanoma, and this is cancer of the melanocytes, and it has very fast metastasis. Its detection uses a rule known as the ABCDE rule. In the ABCDE rule, A stands for asymmetry. On the right side of the slide, you see the figure, and in the figure, the left panel shows you what a normal mole should look like, while the panel on the right side shows you how an abnormal mole looks like, and this abnormal mole could lead to cancer. So A is for asymmetry, which means two sides of the abnormal mole, they do not match. In a normal mole, it should be symmetrical, but in abnormal one, it is asymmetrical. B stands for border irregularity. In normal mole, the borders should be smooth, but in an abnormal mole, the borders are not smooth, they are irregular. C stands for color. For a normal mole, the color should be uniform, it should be same, but for an abnormal mole, it has differential color or pigmentation. D stands for diameter. A normal mole diameter is usually less than 6 millimeters, but if a mole is bigger than 6 millimeters in diameter, that should be a cause for concern. E stands for evolving. A normal mole usually stays same, it does not change in appearance, but if you see that a mole is changing in shape, size, or in elevation, that means you should get that mole checked by a dermatologist.